Well, first, thank you very much for inviting me, CIDC, and the great service that Veral did when we went to Turkey. So thank you for that very kind offer and that very great trip that we had. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, I just wanted to let you know very briefly why I think I am the recipient of a great blessing. And it is true that when I went to see the living Rumi in Konya, my eyes really opened, because in the past, I was always teaching as a professor of political science at Wichita State University, and then as a philosopher there, that in terms of, you all heard about the philosophy of Kant and Descartes and Newtonian physics, and they were teaching us that there is a real gulf between faith and logic, faith and reason, and that that gulf could never be bridged, no matter what happened. Faith is on one side with religion and spirituality, and of course logic and reason, and that gulf will never be bridged. And then you read Rumi, the forefather of quantum physics, who says that every thought leaves a trace on your body. Every thought structures your future every moment. We are never victims. Wow. That to me changed my own philosophy. And it is true that every thought we have, whether it's a thought of fear, you get goosebumps. If it's a thought of embarrassment, you get to blush and you get a chemical shower in your face. And if you happen to have an erotic thought, well, we won't go that way. You get the idea. Imagine if you have an erotic thought, what happens to your body? The blood rushes into every part of the body, the heart rate starts up and so on. But what really struck me was that Rumi showed me the way towards the lie detector test, because every time you're Chief Blair, you will know that, of course, the lie detector test, you know, it is something that is acceptable in court to some degree at least, and most normal people, when they're connected to the lie detector test, every lie shows up as a part on a monitor. So you tell a lie, the whole body responds. Sweat glands, heart pumps, blood pressure. Imagine that. So there is no gulf between logic, reason, and faith. It's one unified field. And that's what Rumi was saying. So to me, that was a real significance. And that's why I was so blessed to go there to see and read the book and really have my eyes opened. So my friends, in the end, every moment, every waking moment we have, we structure our future as we think. Wow, what a revelation. And in the end, yes, it is true. Families are together. We are in the same boat together. And our boat, of course, is the world, the globe. We are hanging in there. One affects the other. But we already know that. Let me simply say to you, I have a letter that I was delighted with Veral, actually, to meet the mayor of Istanbul, the mayor of the municipality of Fatih. And I want to share this with you because he writes that I want to wish all my Canadian friends in the Toronto area the year 2010 to bring you success, good times, happiness, more opportunities to work together, and I wish you a very happy new year, and that is sent to all of us from Mustafa Demir, the mayor of Istanbul. So thank you, Mr. Mayor, and I hope you will respond by giving the mayor a great hand of applause, and we wish to corroborate that with him. So thank you very much. Good evening, since I'm supposed to be wrapping up, and I wish you the very best, and I only hope that all of you take the opportunity. And I know, Veral, please sign me up. I am ready to go.